Well, the markets are giving up a tad bit of steam because the Nifty is now sitting with a gain of around 35 points. When we started off the show, it was showing a gain of around 50 points. And the pressure actually coming from the auto stock. So take a look at Aisha. It had already lost around 10-11% over the last couple of days. And today it is 3% off the day's high. And you can see the decline coming in the auto stocks. Add to that Hero Motor Corp. That one is 2% off its day's high. So some of these stocks coming under a bit of pressure. But other than that, a whole host of stocks are also buzzing in trade today, and Sonal joins in now with all those details. Sonal, good afternoon, over to you.
GM Breweries reported its quarter three numbers, which did not look very good, and that is why the stock is declining in trade today. Well, the EBITDA that declined around 27-odd%, there was some pressure on the margins, also declined by 900 basis points, something that definitely is not taken very positively by the street. Other stock that is in focus is NHPC, because it has informed the exchanges that due to the shutdown of their Parbati power station, they have incurred some losses, and on the interim order, they have incurred a loss of around 24 crore rupees, and according to the final tariff determination by CESC, the loss is around 30 crore rupees. Power Grid is also in focus because the board has approved investment to the tune of 380 crores for two projects. So that's why that stock is buzzing in trade today. Edelweiss is also in focus because there are unconfirmed reports that Edelweiss AMC, that has won the mandate to manage exchange-traded funds. However, these are just reports and CNBC TV18 has not verified them independently. Torrent Power and CESC also in focus because they have won certain bids. Well, CESC has been declared successful bidder for Maligaon Municipal Corporation area, and Torrent Power has been announced a successful bidder for the Thane Urban Circle. So that is positive news coming in for both of them. And Tata Motors, that is one stock buzzing in trade today. Well, the company informed the exchanges about the US JLR sales that have come in higher by around 24-odd%. While the Jaguar sales are up 1.5%, the Land Rover sales, that is up 33%. But remember, these only constitute to around 10-15% of the total sales, and the main number that we'll be watching out for will be the China sales. So this is to be kept in mind before we consider the Tata Motors sale. In the broader markets, there are certain stocks that are buzzing in trade today. IDT Cementation, that is because there has been a large bulk trade that has happened on the stock, and the sugar stocks, they are also in sweet spot, up and buzzing in trade today. Back to you.
Okay, that's a speedy recount of everything that is happening as far as stocks go. Sonal, thanks very much for that. 10,707, there is a pullback which is very evident, almost a 30-point pullback from the highs which we saw just some time back. So the high is 10,741 and we're at about 10,710. Sugar is back in focus, or is it? It actually is the question that we really want to ask. Manisha is here. This talk, and we were discussing some of this yesterday as well, that in Uttar Pradesh, people of course want a higher MSP for sugar prices. Prices are what, 29 rupees a kilo, and they want more. But is it rooted in reality, or people sending up trial balloons to see what is possible? I don't know.
Well, it could be that, you know, but Prashant, the whole conversation has led to one thing positive. So even as we are looking at an increase in the floor prices of sugar from 29 rupees to 32.5, as the UP chief minister has written to the central government, what has happened in last 24 hours is that there has a lot of demand that has come in for sugar in expectation that the sugar prices tomorrow could be expensive. Remember, as we've been talking, nearly 60-65% of sugar consumption in India happens via the institutional buyers. And there has been a lot of demand, as we saw yesterday and today during the day, in case of sugar, as they are expecting the sugar prices to go up. So
this is real sugar demand.
Yes, in expectation that the sugar prices will get expensive going forward. The buying that perhaps was on hold, so the immediate intermittent buying that you have seen has come in, and that's taken the sugar prices much on the higher side. Also, if you look at the last 3 or 4 months, the festive sugar demand was on the higher side. And remember, the Indian government now sets a quota for every month for the sugar mills on how much sugar can they sell into the markets. So for the month of January, it's at 1.85 million tons, which is much lower as what we saw in last few months. Remember, those were festive months as well. So to ensure that the sugar supply in the markets is not too much, the sugar prices are supported. The sugar quota for the month of Jan also has been set slightly lower at 1.85 million. So one, the sugar demand is on the higher side suddenly, and two, the quota for January is on the lower side, and three, there is an expectation that we might see an increase in the MSP of sugar prices. All of these factors really have been supported.
Okay, Manisha, thank you so much for that. So sugar stocks buzzing, but there are a lot of other stocks buzzing as well. Take a look at Kotak Mahindra Bank. That has seen a sudden knock. And even if you look at the Nifty, as we have been pointing out, there has been a pullback because that one is sitting now close to the level of around 10,700. These IT names have been coming under pressure. So Wipro is seeing a bit of further downtick in trade today. So keep an eye out on all these stocks. We'll take a quick break on the show. We'll come back and keep an eye out on the markets for you.